is about classroom technology use, which smartphones, tablets, and other devices can be handed at school, which I always use my tablet. And I started in 2016 at LaGuardia. I had Chromebook, and I was taking all the notes and everything. Although once in a while it was a distraction, but it helped me a lot that I was putting like every note in Google Docs, despite having some class notes on papers here and there. I was, you know, using them and leaving them at work or, you know, somewhere else. But so technology was great, and so it also helped me, you know, type and organize notes and put things in my calendar, remember the events such as this one, and you know, the other ones at CUNY. So I guess I believe that it's gonna replace heavy paper textbooks, which I have about 80 textbooks in this little thing. So instead of carrying heavy books, so I just carry this one. I also I can take notes on textbooks. Okay. So in a recent study by Jeffrey Husnikov at Miami University, college students who watched a videotaped lecture scored lower on tests afterward if they texted about unrelated matters during the class. Okay, according to Argo, when smartphones go to school. So also from my own experience, I try not to, you know, take out my cell phone because I might be distracted, but I usually have my, you know, tablet or, you know, Chromebook. But whenever, you know, like I have a feeling or I'm kind of expecting a text from somebody, I kind of, you know, get lost, but meanwhile I'm just texting back and forth. I try to keep it minimal, but it's a huge distraction, you know, for me as well. And as a result, okay. So in our classroom context observation, cell phones, like time one, is the first half of hour of the class. You see 18% overall. But there are, like, you know, some classes that, like, nobody used their cell phone. Nobody was looking at their cell phone or anything. But I kind of, my hypothesis is, time two, the second half hours, probably out of boredom, and people like took out their cell phones. So I put the laptops. Laptops kind of relevant because it is the technology. Irrelevant in this context because we have a few classes that are all like administrated by computers. Students had, you know, let's say 21 students, all of them. Have to use the computer, so that's why, you know, laptops on the second half hour is like more. And so technology use by course. So my the first one ANC. So there's kind of not enough data, but looking at D, which is cell phone use is the most, and compared to the other D on the other side, with motivation is you realize it's kind of lesser than, let's say, app. And also again, like in this one, next one, okay, so D, for example, when we look at the kind of importance of grading style, is also less. Anyway, like this one was kind of experimental. We didn't have enough data, but it's kind of giving us some kind of, you know, what we're gonna do for our next semesters. And okay, technology use by course, again, D versus okay, the other D. People like mostly like they read text and, you know, send text. Like use of cell phone is like mostly about texting and sometimes, like, you know, massive texting. But here, like, captured as like one time or two times. So next one as well. So this again, motivation is less than the other classes. The cell phones were used less, but anyway, this one is not much, you know, like it's kind of raw data, and hopefully next time I'm gonna do like better observations. So despite flawed data, huge variation between classes in cell phone and laptop use, indication of a negative connection between motivation and cell phone use, indication of a connection between student attitudes and cell phones use, not a consistent connection between observed and reported use of cell phones. Consistent drop in motivation from time one to time two, but great variation by student. Course with the greatest drop in desire to learn was in the course with the most cell phone use. So as like Neil Postman stated once, but Huxley and Orwell debate about, you know, what we like, what we love is gonna kill us. The other one said what we hate is gonna kill us. So it is up to us that whether we like technology or not, is in the way that how we use it and utilize it for our, you know, own